Hello, everyone, and welcome back. This is Vaila Vikasis of the Dark Edge of Light here with a brand new episode of Niche. Now, as I'm sure you're all aware, last episode I actually was slowly starting to have a dwindling population, but had sort of hit some sort of weird equilibrium. Not so anymore. Now, what we've got going down is the fact that I have had to restart because my game file got a little out of date. As is unfortunately wont to happen. And so now we've got to check out the new game. Mostly because we're now over 0.2 on the early access version. They've added in some new genotypes from what I understand. They've added in a new menu here that lets us actually see family trees, which is kind of cool. So you can actually see what the different critters you had going for them. So that's kind of a really, really cool concept. So we've got Adam, and we've got Eve. And as you see, there is now a swimming tail. That's right, you can take it to the water now. So, kind of, sort of, awesome there. That's one of the new functions they've got. And also, as you see, they've greatly expanded the mutation menu. So there's now a lot of new things that can happen on your various critters, which is really, really cool. So again, always happy to see what's going on as they add more and more into these games. They've now got a spiky body, a water body, so you actually have swimming and underwater breathing capabilities. You've now got webbed paws, digging paws, so you can actually dig into the ground for food, which is a brand new concept that they've added in. So just a lot of new little bits and pieces that are going to be really cool. You can even fish now. So there's just a lot of cool stuff, okay? And of course, as always, you can try to force mutations with a 10 and a 30% to try to force the mutations in. To start at least this first play around, we're not going to do that. We're just going to go pretty much as is and see where that takes us. So we've got our buddies here, so let's start off with a normal meeting and with picking fruit. Okay. So we've got our first little youth there, and we're gonna explore a little bit. Oh nice, there we go. It's not such a bad thing, is it? Okay. I love that they follow the cursor. It really is one of the cutest things ever. Let's see. Let's really stock up on some of the foodstuffs here. And now I just want to see, and there, boom, you can see how that family tree has changed. So now if we click on Rousura, you can see who her parents are. So this is going to make things a lot easier for trying to figure out which pairs you haven't bred yet, what types of things you want to do to try to keep the lines strong, because of course the more inbreeding you do, the weaker the lines have the potential to get. Now they still haven't really done much with expanding the size of the map. Obviously that's going to be something that comes later as they keep on developing the game, but the map is definitely a little bit bigger because of the underwater aspects to it, which we're going to try to make use of as soon as we can. Basically, once this guy grows up, we will see what we can do about that. And I'm just curious, you know, I just want to sort of start putting in some ideas here. Ooh, what's that? seashell. So there's a cracking ability now that you can crack open shells. That's interesting. Let's see. Just because I'm interested in the digging paw and the water body here, we're going to see if we can't get some different mutations as we move forward here. There's some more food. Cool. Got a bunch more food trees. That's awesome. I like where we're going with the amount of food in the area here. And of course we've got now currently two females. So hopefully soon we'll be able to find another male or birth another male. But what we should do... There we go, good. So I like that I'm slowly being able to keep up a little better. So I'm curious to see what our new little dude is all about here. So let's check his genetics out. He, in fact, can breathe underwater. Can swim. So he's got water body, swimming tail, and webbed hind legs. Let's see. Runner leg. Okay, good. Interesting. But again, it's another female, which... not 100% sure why all I'm getting is females. So let's try doing another breeding and see what we can figure out in that respect. Gonna spread a little bit, see if we can't try and find some more boys. Okay, so Kurduknu, we can now invite them to join our tribe. Join our tribe, buddy. All right, we've got a new male. Sweet. He's still a little immature, but I think it's still going to be worthwhile. I was pretty sure, yep, there is a nest up there, so that's actually where I'm going to head with you. Well, Adam is going to go get some rabbit. While you prepare to go take a swim. Kill the rabbit. Let's see. Not old enough yet for the mating. Which is fine. Ta-da! New baby. So let's take a look at this tree. Look at that. That's just kind of cool. So you can now see that we have Adam of three different parentages. And we just got a new boy here, who unfortunately also has a club ball. Definitely curious about the whole paw concept there. Huh. Let's make sure the area around our nest is safe. There we go. Hey, it's raining again. Let's see. Well, might as well get him in on some of that action while we're working on stuff here. Fish! Fishes! No idea how I get the fishes, but there are in fact fishes. There we go, new breeding pair. Clear out a little bit of the sides there. All right, so we've animal rank. Interesting. That's apparently something else they've done, is they've added the ability to rank your animals. So you have alpha, beta, and omega, so that now if you're running low on food, you can determine who's going to take the damage. That's kind of cool. Well, there we go. So, we're getting somewhere. It's, you know, not exactly perfect. Rarely is with me. I'm probably going to end up running out of food. Because, you know, that's kind of how I roll. But, hey, it's all in good fun. And survival. There we go. So now we're going to be able to do a mating pair between those two. And Well, I'm kind of excited to see what might happen with the strange blue flipper on my page. Not exactly what I was going for, but I suppose it'll work. Alright, so we're starting to get somewhere interesting here. Nice, there we go. That's some good get. Oh! There goes my first gen. They died. Oh dear, that's bad. Uh-oh. So our first gen's died, unfortunately. And our next gen is in rather extreme danger. As my little Joeys go to work on them. That's hilarious. Ah, well, that's unfortunate. I'm gonna lose that guy far, far sooner than I wanted to. Ooh! Ooh, I can cure the bleeding. That's cool. I like that new option. So I like some of the new behavioral options that they've put in, the different ways that animals would interact with each other in order to help each other. That's very cool. So we're definitely seeing some nifty new concepts here. And there's now a nimble finger concept, so that's also cool. That lets me do 3 gathers with 1 action. So, I mean, they've definitely added in some really amazing new traits. And if we go in here, we can actually, for the fact that that's kind of goofy. So we've got claws for strength and fishing. We've got nimble fingers for collecting and cracking. Okay, so nimble fingers are what you need for that. So, yeah. This is definitely pretty cool. The dots. So all kinds of different things there. Now if we look at our family tree, hey, look at that. Cool. And I guess the black outlines then mean that they have passed on. But definitely a very cool concept, and some really neat stuff they've put in at this point. Let's see. Let's go ahead and spin that clock. So as you can see, we're unfortunately going to lose our noble hunter there. He fought well and valiantly, but unfortunately, he's pretty much fucked. I'm thinking he's got one more spin, which is actually kind of awesome because it looks like that spin may be just enough for him to be able to... Nope, those are all dudes. Well, gather one last bit of food for the tribe, my friend. You'll be missed. Oh, he has one more life in him. How exciting. Feeding from bottom. Ability to dig up underwater fields. Huh. Very interesting. Come back, friend! Where have you gone? Come back, we shall ambassadorize! Oh dear, oh dear, that's bad! Well, at that point, we're going to take a hiatus until the next episode, but as always, I am Vale of Acacius of the Dark Age of Light. You've been watching me play a new episode of Niche with some of the new improvements that have come out. The ability to go underwater, a lot of new ways to be able to gather food, a lot of new mutations to make each turn count a little bit more, and of course the awesome new concept of the family tree so you can really see where your progress has been in the game, how you've been surviving, and how diversified you've managed to make the family overall. So some really cool new concepts that they've added in, and as always, I'm absolutely adoring this game. It's a beautiful game. I mean, that first and foremost, it's an absolutely delightful looking game. The critters and the whole appearance of all of it is just wonderful. And you know, adding into that, which I just accidentally hit space. Just the fact that overall this game has got so much going for it, and it's still so early in development. It's already proven to be such a nifty concept and to have so much going for it. Every single update they do is great. Definitely check it out if you have the opportunity over on Steam. Link will be in the description down below, as it always is. Thank you, as always, to the Niche team. You're making a fantastic game. Keep up the amazing work. I love every bit of it. We'll see you all next time. You can find links to my social media and the social media of the Dark Edge of Light in the description down below. And as always, game on.